Anti-government protesters in Zimbabwe run for cover. Riot police will not let them march to Parliament to hand over their petition. Police follow on foot. Water cannon trucks were used to keep people off the street of Harare and make sure everyone is dispersed. People had been marching against corruption in government and the economy. Unemployed graduates, some of whom are accountants and engineers, say they can't find work. Others don't want the government to introduce a local currency called bond notes. They want to keep using the US dollar and fear using a local currency will lead to hyperinflation. Outside President Robert Mugabe's office, protesters criticized the head of state who's been in power for 36 years.
They're saying hell no to you, the CEO of this country. It's time for you to resign. It's time for you to step down. We now need a new blood. This country is good as it is. What is needed is to change actors. The scripture is good, but we now need new actors of this scripture. And we are now saying Mugabe and his corrupt ministers, they must go. It's time up.
This march in defiance has irritated some of Mugabe's supporters.
I don't want, because Zimbabwe is correct now. There's no problem here. Zimbabwe is correct. Zimbabwe, don't do that. Who's the owner of this function?
President Mugabe's ruling ZANU-PF party has held a meeting over the economy. Officials say things will improve and that Zimbabweans should be patient.
President Mugabe's government promised to create more than 2 million jobs. That still hasn't happened. Unemployed graduates say they're frustrated, they're losing patience. They're saying if the president can't deliver, then he must go.
The show of force from the police sent a message to protesters that demonstrations against the president will not be tolerated. But some citizens say they will plan more protests until the 92-year-old leader does something to fix Zimbabwe's economy or leave office. Haruma Tasa, Al Jazeera, Harare.